Good afternoon, Southside. I'm Enrico Reed. This week, we'll take a look at a student who got a full out-of-state scholarship. We'll tell you how he did it and how you can do it too. Plus,
I'm Kayla Hornsberry. If you think this is bad, just imagine what would happen to you at work.
I'm Kelvin Douglas, and I know what you're thinking. Why am I here in the locker room? Well, I am deep inside the Hawks' nest for an interview with one of our senior football players. Hawk TV starts now.
Welcome back to Hawk TV. Some of you may know senior Colton Johnson, but for those of you who don't, here's how he managed to receive a full ride scholarship to a university college.
Miss Webb, a Southside High School English teacher, is holding an after-school ACT practice program to help out all the students who need practice and for the students who didn't get to take her ACT prep class.
This program will be held after school every Thursday. This program just started, so they've only had one meeting.
I got together with senior Leland Williamson to talk about the first ACT prep practice meeting.
Yes, Miss Webb has been working with me a lot to get just helping me do better on everything.
I asked Leland if he is nervous about the ACT.
Just a little bit, but Miss Webb is helping us out to get more comfortable with it. The more practice you do, the better.
I also asked him if he expects any miracles out of this program.
I hope so.
If you are looking to see how your ACT score is important and how it can help you in the future, Colton Johnson is a prime example.
Last week I got called and offered a free ride to Capital University in Columbus, Ohio. Ms. Tucker was talking to one of the guidance counselors outside the office, and somebody said they heard them mention me, and they thought it was something bad, so they told me to go out there and check. And when I went out there, I asked them why they were talking about me, and they said, oh, you did really badly on your ACT. And I got so scared, and they said, yeah, you made a 31, you gotta bring that up. And it was terrifying. Said not having to pay is gonna be a huge thing, because I really couldn't afford it before. So, I mean, just the chance to go to college is a huge thing that this has gotten for me, and I'm really looking forward to it.
Thanks, Erica. Seniors, get out your calendars, and don't forget that on Monday, September 23rd, there'll be a project graduation meeting at 6 p.m. in the East Campus Library. After this short commercial break, we'll show you a few highlights from a senior football player from last week's game.
Okay, class, Jackson Reed's Millions is a reading initiative that the school system wants us to do. All you need to do is to pick up this little log right here, and you just fill it out. And when you finish, you drop it into a drop box that's around campus. And when you read a million words, you will get entered into a drawing to maybe win an iPad.
Man, reading is so boring. I don't read. No way could I read a million words. I'd never get that iPad.
Oh, yes, you do.
Whoa, who are you?
I'm your conscience, and yes, you do read all the time.
You're crazy. I have to go.
See there, you're reading.
What are you doing in here? And this is just Twitter, not a book.
Just because it's not a book doesn't mean you're not reading. There are still words. You can read anything. Social networks, sports reviews, even blogs.
So it doesn't have to be a book?
Nope.
Well, I could probably do that. Now, can I have some privacy?
Oh, yeah. Find some words to read today, Southside. A million starts with one.
Welcome back. Hawk TV reporter Kelvin Douglas has a story on the return of senior football player Alec Forrest.
Alec Forrest is a senior wideout for the Southside football team. Alec is not yet satisfied with how the team is doing.
So far, we could have done better, but I feel like in the future, we're ultimately going to end the season on a good note.
Alec has played football since his freshman year and made a lot of memories.
The most memorable moment was, for me, ever playing football was my junior year whenever I was still on JV and I made this tackle and I took a dude off his feet.
The Southside Hawks may be struggling, but don't mistake that for a weakness. They are definitely getting stronger.
Every day we try to improve and we try to get better, so I think that we're improving.
Alex suffered a concussion in the game against Crockett County and had to sit out in the game against Fairwell. When I talked to him, however, he said he was just okay, the Hawks won.
It really sucked because all I could do is just kind of stand on the sidelines. I couldn't contribute to us winning, but ultimately I'm still happy that we won against Fairwell, so it happens.
Alex said that he wishes to continue football in his college years, but if that doesn't work out, he is just going to focus on school.
Well, I would ultimately like to play college football, but if that does not happen, then I would like to major in engineering at any technical institute. So.
For Hawk TV, I'm Kelvin Douglas.
Thanks, Kelvin. Ms. Dalton is pre-selling homecoming shirts until next Friday, September 27th. Short sleeves are $15 and long sleeves are $20. Here's a sneak preview of what they will look like. Monday night was the Lady Hawks soccer spirit night, and though they lost, it was a great game, and they are still getting full support.
At that moment, it hit me. This is why I joined the Guard. I couldn't believe it. I just saved a life. Somebody from my hometown. Be there for your community at NationalGuard.com.
For those of you who thought the strict cell phone rules at school were not valid anywhere else, think again. Hawk TV reporter Kayla Thornsberry tells us why.
Using your phone can become a problem in more places than just school. When you get a job, most companies that hire teens have a phone policy.
I work at Panera Bread Company in the Columns. We are not supposed to be on our cell phones while we are on the clock, but at times, like after we've closed, because I close a lot, they let us be on our cell phones as long as there's no customers in there.
We all know that we will do almost anything to check our phones for that one text message, even though we could get in a lot of trouble for it. Rico Reed, employee of Popeyes, let us and on a few of his hiding places.
If I want to get on my phone at work, I usually go where there are not any cameras, and so they'll probably be like in the cooler or in the hallway lobby.
At school, the worst thing that could happen is being suspended for not giving up your phone. But getting caught on your phone at work could cost you your job.
Because, like, where I work is a fast food restaurant, and if we're in a real busy rush and you're on your phone, and a customer sees it, they can turn you into corporate. And you will be at a chance of losing your job.
Having managers on their phone could be a serious problem in the workplace as well, especially for other employees.
To an extent, if they're doing something business related, then I think that it's all right. But most of the time, they're not, because like they'll go and they'll be on Facebook or something in the back, and I'll be up there ringing someone in, and I'll be asking for their help, and they'll just stay back there.
Punishments for phones at work can sometimes be totally different depending on the place, as we will see from Rico and Dalton.
Yes, if we are caught on our phone the first time is a warning. Second time, you are going to be asked to put it up, and you will be written up. Third offense, you will be sent home.
We don't really have a punishment. They basically just tell us not to be on our phones, but, I mean, that works. We're not supposed to be on them. I think that if you are on your phone a lot, though, eventually they do need to, like, write you up or do something about it.
Phones can be more trouble than you think. I know this from experience. For Hawk TV, I'm Kayla Thornsberry.
The broadcasting three students participated in a statewide contest. Here's an entry by Kelsey Key and Tredarius Cannon. They'll be entering the contest for a $500 scholarship.
School. 7 hours of teachers talking about things that are anything but interesting. But some teachers take a boring subject and make it something that students want to learn about. My government and economics teacher, Mr. Dane Weaver, is one of those teachers.
What amendment have we violated? Amendment A? I've missed something.
Mr. Weaver always interacts with his students, making learning interesting and easy to comprehend.
Mayo, if you were President Obama, would you tax Syria? Come on. Put your finger on the button, son. You're on camera. Do a close-up.
We're not the only students who think Mr. Weaver is a great teacher.
And he makes class interesting, and it's not a boring class at all. We're very involved in class, and we do a lot of things together.
He's like a really cool teacher, and he teaches you different things that you wouldn't learn in like a normal classroom.
Not only is Mr. Weaver positively influencing the way we learn, he is also helping students prepare for college and the real world. Schools all over the country need teachers like Mr. Weaver to make learning something we want to do instead of something we have to do.
Ms. Weaver techniques are fun, interactive, and should be used by teachers all over the country. I'm Sherry Cannon.
And I'm Kelsey Key.
Thanks for watching this edition of Hawk TV. We leave you today with another segment of 60 Selling Silly Faces. See you next week.